Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this new virtual event. And thank you for joining in. I'm Andrea Arbarelli, and today's streaming is all about pipe extrusion technology, a topic that, we know, interests many of you. Today, our speakers will provide you with an insight into Bausano's PVC pipe extrusion technology. And they show you how Bausano has responded to the increasing demand for pipes and with what solutions. Moreover, to give you a practical example of the application of this technology, we will show you a video contribution from one of our customers. This way, you'll see some of the projects we developed in the past and those that we have kept on developing during the last month. So, to give you a better idea of just what you can expect from a company like Bausano. Finally, we will share with you the solutions we have adopted to keep guaranteeing a fast and reliable customer service despite the pandemic and the consequent remote working and travel restriction. I hope all of this sounds appealing to you and that you will enjoy attending this new open day as much as we did organizing it. Now, before further proceeding, let me just tell you that you can send all your questions by email at events@bausano.com. Questions regarding any of the topics we will touch upon today. We'll make sure to answer to them during the Q&A section at the end of the event. Now, I leave the floor to our Vice President, Mr. Clemente Bausano.
Thank you very much, Andrea. The global PVC pipe market reach a volume of 25 million tons in 2020. And in the forecast period of 2021-2026 is expected to grow at an annual rate of about 5% and so to get the target of 30 million tons in 2026. The market is currently being driven by growing urbanization, rising construction activities and infrastructure developments, along with growing demand in chemical, oil and natural gas industry. In this context, we have become more focused on solution and application than ever before. We have completely redesigned our equipment for the extrusion of every kind of pipe, from rigid to soft, from transparent to highly filled or pressure pipe, in order to meet our customer requirements. The main innovation include the launch of a completely redesigned new generation of die heads. In particular, we offer a range of models for the manufacturing of PVC pipes, either in double exit up to 200 mm or single exit up to 1 meter for a maximum production of up to 2 tons per hour. At the same time, we have made a significant gain in speed, providing fast response time and availability of machines, spare parts and expert support. It is more important than ever for us to offer comprehensive solutions. Benefits from our expertise in production processes, digital and service area along the entire value chain.
Thank you very much to our Vice President. Now, before actually showing you the testimony from one of our customers, my colleague Roberto Sardella will give you a quick lecture about the different pipes you can extrude with our solutions.
Good afternoon, my name is Roberto Sardella. And for those which are unfamiliar with us, Bausano is a family-run company founded in 1946, designing and manufacturing extrusion lines for plastic processing since the very beginning. For over 70 years, we have focused on quality, flexibility and attention paid to every single need of each of our customers and projects. In the 80s, we patented our extruder gearbox called Multi-Drive that characterize all our TwinSQ extruders. As previously mentioned, we have invested heavily in product innovation in order to renew and update our extrusion lines for rigid PVC and for polyethylene pipes as well. Talking about pipes, we have to consider that they can be applied in many different fields, from construction to infrastructure, water supply networks, gas pipelines and telecommunication networks, with a wide range of uses also in agricultural, medical, mining, oil and automotive industries. All these sectors have something in common. They require high quality production. They require high production speed, and they require an excellent ratio between output and energy consumption. Today's event is focused on a PVC pressure pipe extrusion line. Nevertheless, our complete lines equipped with our single or twin screw extruder are suitable for the production of PVC pipes and doses, which includes rigid PVC called UPVC, usually for transportation of drinking water, waste, sewage, drainage, wells, industrial application, electrical conduits, up to the agricultural hoses and conduit. Soft PVC hoses, which are used in agricultural mainly, can be reinforced with textile insertion or co-extruded with spiral rigid PVC, as well as galvanized steel. Chlorinated PVC, called CPVC, a popular choice for pipes and fitting for drinking water transportation, carrying water with a wide range of temperature, and also handling industrial liquids. Non-toxic PVC and other vinylic materials specific for sanitary application, like medical tubes and medical bags. Polyolefin pipe, which includes LDPE and HDPE pipes for water and gas distribution, single or multi-layer. PEX, PERT, PPR, mono or multi-layer pipes for typical residential installation. Latest generation of polypropylene PPHM, also available as three-layer solid foam solid, suitable for drainage pipes in civil constructions. And last, polyethylene pipe for telecommunication and cable ducts.
Thank you, Roberto. So, as you have heard, Bausano Solutions can cover most of the requirements of plastic pipe producers. In case of special requirements, we also complete our portfolio with tailor-made high-performance solutions. Our goal is to offer to you, our customers, reliable and economically advantageous means to boost both the quality of the final product and the production capacity. This is in fact the only way to cope with the many needs of the market and to increase your market share. This is even more true in difficult times such as the one we have lived in recent months. Now, the event of today is focused on PVC pipe extrusion. And to show you a practical application of this technology, we have asked permission to one of our customers to enter his factory and show you our lines in action. Please, enjoy this interview with Mr. La Scala of Industry IPL, Industria Plastica La Scala, who kindly agreed to share with us some words of appreciation on the long-term collaboration between our companies.
Good morning, I'm Gianluca from IPL. IPL has a 40-year tradition in the plastic industry. IPL is a small-medium enterprise located in the industrial area of Belpasso, Catania. It was founded by my grandfather, Dino La Scala, who has started the business with the production of plastic pipes and shutter profile extrusion. Has been continued till today by his natural successors, Sergio and Concetta La Scala.
La nostra linea di produzione è di tubi in PVC per edilizia, per fognature, per cavidotti, per applicazioni come pluviali e quindi sul range di diametri che vanno dal millimetri 32 fino ad arrivare al 500 per le applicazioni delle fognature stradali. Abbiamo sviluppato molto anche i cavidotti per la protezione di cavi elettrici, ma la prevalenza è quella relativa ai tubi in PVC per lo scarico negli edifici e nella termosanitaria. La scelta di collaborare con l'azienda Bausano è avvenuta alla fine degli anni 90. Iniziammo con un piccolo estrusore per i tubi alla fine degli anni 90, finché poi queste linee sono state succedute da altre linee, fino ad arrivare a 7-8 linee complete che abbiamo comprato negli ultimi 20 anni di attività assieme a loro. E quindi io già ne approfitto dell'opportunità per ringraziarli, perché ovviamente le linee Bausano per noi sono state molto affidabili, ci hanno dato garanzia di successo, di continuità di lavoro, di assistenza, di vicinanza, pur essendo loro a Torino e noi a Catania, ci siamo resi conto di essere con loro molto vicini, perché a ogni nostra richiesta subito c'è stata una pronta risposta. Ci hanno collaborato anche in certi momenti di difficoltà per qualche intoppo tecnico che è avvenuto in qualche linea di estrusione, magari per una manovra errata qualche volta, e quindi è successo che questo ha fatto sì che l'azienda Bausano si è messa a disposizione nostra per risolvere questi problemi. La scelta prevalente avvenne quando ci furono prospettati gli estrusori con gli inverter, che hanno portato sicuramente a quella che è la trasmissione del moto un buon risultato. L'inverter ha portato al sincronismo dei motori e quindi, in funzione alla struttura e all'entità dell'estrusore, questi motori, due o quattro motori, hanno trasmesso tramite questi inverter quel moto giusto per far andare le macchine. Ovviamente anche l'affidabilità dei cilindri e delle viti li riteniamo abbastanza valide. L'usura è minore, perché in certe linee di prodotti, tipo i tubi per l'edilizia, si viene a utilizzare un po' di carbonato di calcio, e quindi il fatto che queste viti girano sempre e comprimono sempre, insomma, masticano e fanno la plastica. E quindi su questo non abbiamo avuto mai niente a che ridire. E ovviamente anche gli impianti a corredo, tipo i tunnel di calibrazione, o recentemente su una nuova linea che abbiamo realizzato, la realizzazione della testa, e quindi fanno sì di completare questa gamma ed essere completi per quelle che sono le produzioni pertinenti. Un altro vantaggio delle linee Bausano è quello che abbiamo riscontrato nei quadri a piede delle macchine, in quanto rispetto ai quadri di una volta, le loro dimensioni rappresentano quello che oggi magari un operatore si può trovare in modo più comodo e consono per quello che è lo svolgimento delle varie sequenze. E lavorando su tre turni di produzione, nelle ore di notte o di mattina presto, dove magari si è un po' più stanchi, è bene che questi numeri vengano ben evidenziati. E le dimensioni dei quadri adesso realizzati, e anche degli ultimi decenni, sono abbastanza positivi e diciamo abbastanza validi per questo tipo di operazioni. Sicuramente il fatto di essere touchscreen adesso ha portato un vantaggio, perché non c'è più la possibilità di muovere delle manopole e quindi magari regolare. Le sequenze sono più limpide da vedere e da eseguire, e tutti quelli che sono i parametri della conduzione della macchina e anche di quello che è a valle della macchina vengono riportati su tutti questi quadri, che danno dei buoni risultati per quello che riguarda l'affidabilità e alla conduzione e alla sicurezza della macchina.
Many, many thanks to Mr. La Scala of IPL, Industria Plastica La Scala. And this is just one of the many projects Bausano has developed in 75 years of history. Now, before further proceeding to the second, more practical part of the event, let me just remind you that you can send all your questions by email at events@bausano.com. We will answer as many as possible at the end of this broadcast, live here from the studio. Are you now ready to hear more about the technical features of Bausano's PVC pipe extrusion technology? I'm glad to welcome my colleague, Giorgio Critelli.
Thank you very much, Andrea, for your example. Now, ladies and gentlemen, from your feedback, we know that some of you have already been involved in the production of pipe for some time and would like to expand this business area. I'll now give you an overview of the latest technology we have developed here in Bausano. As you know, besides the extruder, the pipe pad is one of the most important components in a pipe extrusion line. Many factors contribute to making Bausano pipe pads the right choice for cost-effective PVC production and premium pipe quality. Single spider distributor-based pipe heads are the most common concept of equipment for the production of compact PVC pipes. But we also have extensive experience in the construction of double spider pipe heads. These heads offer distinctive advantages in the production of thick PVC pipes thanks to their offset positioning. Our pipe head range can cover up to 800 millimeters pipe diameter. Our pipe head can be also equipped with reducing adapter to extend the diameter range covered. This way, you'll be able to produce smaller pipe without the need to switch to a smaller pipe head. We mainly use hardened chrome steel for the pipe head and die set components. These are materials specially selected to suit the operating conditions. In order to save time and money, the line must reach a stable and continuous production state after the shorter startup time. Our pipe heads are therefore characterized by their ease of handling and design that is adapted to the operating conditions. For example, positioning balls ensure that pipe head segments are mounted in the correct position. Mounting trolley allows pipe head alignment. The flow of Bausano's pipe heads for PVC is engineered to ensure the quality and dimensional accuracy of the pipes. The flow channel volumes are coordinated to maximum throughput. Flow optimized mandrel support ribs ensure smoother and more uniform melt flow. The die set design enhances pressure balancing in the pipe head. Individually controlled resisting heating pads ensure that all essential pipe head components are heated in the right temperature. The number of heating pads depend on pipe head size. We also offer a mandrel temperature control option, which is beneficial in processing temperature-sensitive materials. To optimize material consumption, there is a continuous gravimetric melt throughput measurement and meter weight adjustment and thermal pipe head centering. To minimize the wall thickness fluctuation, the system allows you to regulate individually the temperature of the different die zones. The different die zones are divided by slits into thermally separated heating zones for the purpose of thermal centering. The heating zones can be regulated individually, either manually or automatically in conjunction with ultrasonic wall thickness measurement. Which are the advantages? That MIES flow channels geometries are adapted to the size of the pipe heads. This allows you to have a wide throughput and pipe dimension range. Minimize the pipe overweight with excellent surface and best pipe quality. Processing of all standard PVC compound and stabilizer. User-friendly and robust design with easy handling in production and setup cycles. High quality of the material and improved design gives high operational reliability as well as easy maintenance with little effort. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to show you how our vacuum tanks actually works. We can adapt our vacuum tanks to the individual applications. This means that we have the perfect solution for almost every size and requirement. These are the advantages. Complete solution made from stainless steel. Easy height, horizontal and longitudinal adjustment. Cold water temperature control. Energy saving with optimally designed pumps. To avoid the pipe ovalization and optimize the production, a precise designing of the calibrators is needed. The pipe extrusion process is more and more driven by quality and production speed. So vacuum tanks have become much more important elements for the efficiency of the production cycle. The tanks are designed in different lengths to cool pipes up to diameter 800 mm, with one or two chambers or in according to our customers' needs. Bausano vacuum cooling tanks offer the best performance available. The tanks are manufactured to the highest quality in according to the design that is easy to operate, easy to install, and easy to maintain. After the vacuum section or the vacuum tanks, we find the cooling tanks. Here, the pipe is cooled down by spraying water on its surface. Cool water is supplied to maintain the set temperature and the water level is kept constant with an overflow outlet. There are multiple aluminum covers with a sealing rubber insert in the top of the tank. The spray nozzles are fixed alongside it. The in and outlet seals will be adapted to the pipe diameter. Depending on the application, pipe support can be done with rollers or discs. The tank's base is welded construction. The height can be adjusted by turning two screws in each console. Which are the advantages of the cooling units? Standard long-lasting air-controlled valves, suitable for contaminated water. New water level control, not sensitive to contaminated water. Construction of rigid and robust stainless steel. Stable vacuum and efficient cooling. Quick tool change that reduces costs. High efficient electronic motors. Water temperature control. Thank you very much for your attention. I'll now give the floor to my colleague.
Thank you, Giorgio. And once again, I remind you that you can send all your questions by email at events@bausano.com. We're now ready for the, I think, the more interesting part of the event, which is the live test of our MD7530. So let's go live from our test room. And as you can see, our technicians already begun with the extrusion. Today, we are extruding PNC PVC pressure pipes diameter 110 mm. The material we are using today has been supplied by TPV Compound, the Italian leader in the formulation and production of rigid compounds for extrusion and injection molding applications. It's a dry blend of rigid PVC for pressure pipes. Let's now have a look at how the line is composed. Here you can see the drive motors. Our MD75 extruder is operated by two three-phase induction motors, 18.5 kW each, which are controlled by a single frequency converter. Both the motors are connected to the gearbox. The whole drive system and the truss bearing are housed in a cast iron casing. This is our famous multi-drive gearbox. To check the back pressure on the truss bearings, a load cell is installed as well. The feeding system is equipped with a volumetric hopper with a vertical feeding screw conveyor. The barrel of this MD75 is made of nitrated steel. The barrel heating is provided by ceramic heating vents with electric heaters powered in single phase with 220 volt voltage. It is air-cooled by means of cooling fans. The screws are also made of nitrided steel. The screw geometry has been specifically designed by our engineers so to optimize the processing of the material tested today. The inside of the screws is drilled to allow the circulation of silicone oil. The circulation of the cooling oil is regulated by means of a thermoconditioning control unit. The oil temperature can also be set from the extruder control panel. A degassing system is installed on the barrel. The venting is controlled by a liquid ring pump installed on the base of the extruder. The degassing system is equipped with a double filter that can be easily inspected during the operations. Our extruder is also equipped with a pressure transducer, which is used to check the extrusion pressure. The probe enters a hole in the collector, as you see on your screens, and it measures the material pressure at the inner wall. The value is then displayed on the control panel. At the same time, the probe also measures the T-melt. And here we have the die head, the one my colleague Giorgio already showed you in all its components. The head installed in this line have a range that covers from diameter 63 to diameter 110 mm. Let's now have a look to our digital extruder control 4.0. This has been designed to provide the continuous energy screening of the entire system. The new integrated control system measures all the energy flows by processing reports and graphics in real time. This allows you to check the energy consumption with absolute precision in every moment of the production cycle. The system is equipped with a 21-inch capacitive multi-touch widescreen. Through this system, it is also possible to adjust and monitor process parameters such as the extruder speed, the forcer speed, the torque, or the hall-off and cutter speed. The individual speeds can be adjusted separately or in synchro mode. It is also possible to adjust and monitor the thermoregulation of the extruder through the real-time display of the process temperatures, both the set temperature and the measured temperature, and the energy consumption in terms of instantaneous real power and reactive power of each individual zone of the barrel and of the die head. To facilitate the setting of the extrusion parameters, it is possible to save and process recipes and processing data. The saved recipes can be easily recalled and reset with a simple touch. Our digital extruder control can be as well equipped with our Orchestra software for Industry 4.0. This software allows the monitoring of the extrusion parameters and facilitate the maintenance operation and also allow you to use a predictive maintenance strategy. Now, as you've seen on the screen, we are actually producing more than 300 kilos per hour, which means an extrusion speed of 4 meters per minute of this PN6 PVC rigid pipe, diameter 110 millimeters. And now let's have a look at the rest of the line. We start, as you see, with the vacuum tank. The pipe vacuum tank is, of course, used to shape the pipe from the melt. As we told you, we can offer solutions also for the manufacturing of very large PVC pipes up to 800 millimeters. And of course, this is not the case for the tank we have here. The calibration tank is made of stainless steel, and on the base you can see the water ring vacuum and water recirculation pumps, along with the independent vertical and transverse front and rear adjustment systems. When the pipe exit the vacuum and cooling section, it is now perfectly formed, so we have the hollow and the cutting unit to complete the pipe extrusion line. Here you can see the final product obtained from our demonstration. As you see, the surface is smooth with a uniform color. I think we can be satisfied with the results of our light test. So let me just tell a big thank you and a big bravo to all the colleagues in the test department. Before actually answering to all the questions you sent us, I have a couple of questions myself. Where is Bauzano heading in the development of this technology? And to what extent Bauzano's new proposal make a difference to our customers? I'm sure Clemente Bauzano has the right answer to these questions.
Yes, you know very well that one of the costs that is impacting more on the total cost of a plastic company is related to energy consumption. And this is why we have invested and we are investing more and more in order to help our customer to save money whenever energy is concerned. More or less, the energy cost is the third largest cost that a plastic company has to face, considering the total industrial cost. So it means that if we can make a difference for the customer in terms of energy consumption, we will be really able to help them in be more competitive than before. So our efforts have been concentrated more and more in this direction, and we have developed certain solutions that we are sure can be very useful for all of our customers. One of the most important, one of the most recent ones, is related to the induction heating system of the barrel. That is a completely different system compared to the traditional heating system with the ceramic vents, and that allows the customer to save on an average of 25-30% of the total power consumed. Along with this innovation, that is something that I really believe it's special, we have also improved more than in the past the gearbox system, our multi-drive gearbox system, that is completely manufactured in-house, and that is that has been designed in order to give two main advantages to our customers. The first one is related to the useful life of the whole system, because due to the fact that the power is divided, the power and transmission divided by four motors instead of the traditional one, single one, the torsional effect and the stress on the gears and shaft is much lower if compared with the traditional transmission system. And the second effect is that due to the geometry, or the design of the gearbox itself, the power necessary to transmit the energy from the motors to the screws is lower if compared to the traditional extruder that are just using one single motor. So it means that if you compare our extruders with other ones, you will see that to get the same output in terms of kilogram per hour, in our case you need a lower installed capacity in terms of kilowatt hour. So it means that these two effects, along with the induction heating system on the barrel, will permit to our customers to save a huge amount of power, and so consequently a huge amount of money.
All right, thank you very much, Clemente. And let's now have a look at the question you sent us. And the first one that I have here is very interesting. And to be honest, it's something that I myself would ask if I were a customer. In terms of fast response, availability of spare parts and technical expert, how has Bausano faced this COVID emergency? And how has he managed to keep ensuring the fastest and the best possible customer service all around the world?
Of course, COVID pandemic has been a great challenge for our company, but since the beginning we have started to think about a solution for both the service issue and the spare part one. So we have invested in order to find a way to be present in remote with our customer whenever they require any kind of assistance. So we have launched a new application that is called Acti, and that can be downloaded on any device, any possible device like iPad or mobile phone or laptop, whatever. And with this kind of application, our customer can be guided by our headquarters in Italy in order to be able to check their line and find along with us anytime there is a kind of problem and to be guided in order to solve it.
And by the way, Clemente, we recently had an entire show explaining how we supply and service the United States market. We also have created a worldwide network of technicians which are able to reduce the downtime as much as possible. Apart from the Italian headquarters, from which, with short notice, we can organize intervention all over the world, we have a technical service in Brazil, covering the whole Central and South America market. Another that operates in the United States, and another from Australia. To sum up, we have a large stock of spare parts for all our products, included those that are out of production, so we can minimize the downtime even in the event of significant breakdown. Our technicians are always available to a real-time support to our customer and also to reach them in short time anywhere in the world, allowing the customer to restart the production as quick as possible. This is a very important point.
Okay, well, thank you. And it comes another question for you. It says you talked about diet technologies. Has Bausano already installed multiple strand exit lines? And which are their features in terms of output and pipe dimensions?
This is a good question, thank you. Yes, we have invested a lot in developing a new range of solution for pipelines. Everybody knows that when we talk about pipelines, the two main components are the screws and the die heads. So we have completely redesigned the die heads, the family of our die heads, as well as the screw for pipe application. Now we are able to supply different solutions for all our customers' need. When I said different solution, I mean that we can supply a 4-exit pipeline up to 25 millimeter. We can supply double exit for pipeline always up to 200 mm, that it's not that common. And also single exit for the biggest size of pipes.
Thank you, Clemente. So let's have a look at another question from our audience. What progress has been made in recent years by Bausano to optimize the performance of extrusion lines so to process customer-specific materials? Whoever wants to answer, just go ahead.
Well, I think I can take this question. Along the years, we collected a rich database based on the rheological analysis of different materials provided by our customers. This allow us to optimize the configuration of the combination between dosing system, skew geometry, and dye flow dye geometry. We also use innovative software to calculate the dye geometry and the screw configuration, which allow us to proper design the mechanical components of our machines. Anyhow, efficient extrusion requires proper instrumentation. Most critical process variables are the melt pressure, the melt temperature, and the motor load. They are, during the process, the vital signs of the extrusion process and must be continuously monitored. But other important parameters are also monitored in our machine in order to control the process system, such as the barrel and die screw, barrel and die temperature, sorry, the screw speed, the screw flow rate, the screw thermoregulation unit, the power consumption is very important, the level of the gassing vacuum, the load on the thrust bearing system. All these parameters are continuously monitored and stored by the digital touchscreen PLC with which our extruders are normally equipped.
Yes, just adding something more to what Roberto is saying, I would like to highlight that all the main components of our pipe extrusion lines are manufactured in-house. So, I mean specifically the gearbox itself completely, screws, barrel, and also the die heads and calibrators. Concerning the die, I would like to emphasize that we have developed a kind of die heads that are able to produce pipe in a much better way compared to the past, especially when we talk about pressure pipe. Moreover, we have invested in designing and studying a solution that allows to our customer to reduce the downtime as much as possible. So it means that the design of our diets has been thought in order to switch very quickly from one diameter to the other, and also to change thicknesses in a speed that is much higher than in previous time.
Perfect. Thank you very much, guys. And one more question. It says we have talked about efficient production, and in these terms, we can consider also the reduction of wasted materials during production. What if customers ask if we have any solutions to reduce the initial wastage in the extrusion process?
Right, Andrea, thank you very much. We have been pioneers in pipe extrusion for 70 years now. In this time, we have developed our totally independent two-chamber calibration tanks that allow a fast and efficient startup and minimize the waste. In our double zone tanks, it is possible to apply a vacuum in the first short sector of the tank and perfectly extrude the pipe in very short time, limiting and saving the waste during the startup. What we are, generally speaking, what we are doing in Bausano is putting the customers in the center of our action. We don't consider ourselves as only simply seller of extrusion lines, but we are a solution provider to our customers. We want to understand the challenge, the problem they have, and together to develop and find the right answer and solution to them. We are able really to tailor-made this machine exactly on the needs of our customers.
Great, Roberto, thank you. We are running out of time, so just one last question. Customers ask if it's possible to produce CPVC pipes with our extruders. Giorgio, I'd say this is for you.
Thank you, Andrea. First of all, for those who are not involved with this material, CPVC is PVC that has been chlorinated via a chlorination reaction. In this process, chlorine is added, replacing a portion of hydrogen. CPVC is mainly used for hot water transportation pipe. Because of high Glanzner's transition temperature, high heat distortion temperature, and flake and smoke properties. Now, due to the high viscosity of this material, we have to deal with the high generated back pressure. CPVC needs a stronger gearbox to support the torque and the lower processing temperature. Lower temperature avoids the degradation of the polymer. Doing it increases even more the viscosity of the CPVC and generate an even higher back pressure during the extrusion process. To eliminate the torsion effort on the common shafts, also increasing the thrust bearing system, we have developed a special gearbox called multi-drive. This gearbox has been created with a goal to resist to high back pressure and torque parameters. So, to answer to the question, yes, Bausano can supply a complete CPVC granulation line and CPVC pipelines, both in single and double strand.
Thank you, Giorgio. And at this point, I'd like to thank again Clemente Bausano and Roberto Sardella for all the useful insights they shared with us today. And of course, I thank all of you for joining us in the event of today. It has been amazing having you here. And I would also express my gratitude for all the interest you showed in our products and services. We'll make sure to answer all the other questions we received that we could not address today due to time constraints. Moreover, we will soon send you the link with the event recording of today, and we would be grateful if you could share it with other interested parties. Moreover, if you could leave us a comment or a feedback on the event of today, that would be great, because this will help us to further improve, which is always our goal. So, thank you again, have a wonderful day, but most importantly, please stay healthy. See you soon!